So I think, you know, we need a servant leadership in Africa, rather than, you know, leaders wants to be served by the people. That has to change. I think we need to expand the civil society. Without the civil society, you know, the government's very much role without any check and balance. I think we need, the African, based on our culture and history, a democratic transition. I think the diaspora or the intellectual, the elite class, who sometimes are also aiding and abetting the system, needs to do some self-examination. You know, as you said, Africa is rich, we have resources, but if we don't know how to manage what you have, it's barren, you know, it has no value. So I think it's very, very important for African leaders and African intellectuals to ask the question, how long are we going to be enduring this crisis? How many years can we be a recipient of foreign aid when we have plenty in our own country? I think that the international community also need to think, you know, Africa should not be in a position to be ruled or by foreign aid rather than by supporting Africans, you know, to support themselves. So there's a lot I can say, but at the end of the day, I think we need servant leaders in Africa. Until we get them, we have this fake election we do every 4 years, sometimes every five years, and then we create this system. I mean, somebody has been in a position for 35 years, you know, it creates its own class of people, so they don't want to give up. So that's part of the challenge we have. You know, we need to have a term limit. They keep changing the constitution every time they want to stay in power, and we have seen it, you know, from North Africa all the way Central and West Africa and East Africa now. So I think we need to take an example of the South Africa, the newest country. You know, in such a short period of time, they had election and they have actually chosen different people to take them to the next level, given all the crisis and what they inherited. So I think that's going to be my message. But I think the message is also for our people. We shouldn't accept the status quo. I understand, you know, these leaders have military behind them. They have tanks and jets. But at the same time, we have to say enough is enough. We can't go on like this. And we want to make, you know, our continent a better place for its people.